Hi children, in the previous class you have learnt about forming two digit and three digit numbers with and without repetition. I hope you understood. Today let us learn about odd and even numbers. Okay. Even and odd numbers. So, what are even and odd numbers? First, let us see what are even numbers. Okay, even numbers. So, you know that. What do you mean by pay? While purchasing. For example, we say pair of shoes, isn't it? Pair of arms, pair of shoes. What is the meaning of pair? Pair means group of two. Okay, group of two. For example, here there are two apples. If we group them together, we say that it is a pair of apples. A pair of apples. A pair means there will be two apples. Pair means two. Okay. Pair means two. So here, even numbers means numbers which we can make pair. Numbers which can be grouped into pairs are called even numbers. For example, so here I have two balls. I can make it into a group. I can group them in one, isn't it? A pair. It is pair of ball. In the same way, here I have four balls. Okay, I have four balls. Even this, I can make it into pair. Two in one group. Here another two in another group. Like this. So in the same way, here I have six balls. Okay, how many? Six balls are there. So this can be grouped into two in a group. So you can say that three pairs of balls. There are three pairs here. Three pairs means in a pair two balls. So three pairs means total six balls. Here there are three pairs. Here there are two pairs. Here there is a pair. Got it? Like this. Such numbers are called even numbers. Okay. Such numbers are called even numbers. So, numbers like 0, numbers like 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 are called even numbers. Okay. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. These numbers are called even numbers. Okay. These numbers can be made a pair. We can make them group of two. Okay. We can make them into group of two. Such numbers are called even numbers. And odd numbers. Odd numbers are, we cannot make them into pair. For example, if I have only a ball, one ball. It is only one. We cannot make group it into two, isn't it? And in the same way, if I have three balls, what happens? Only I can make one group and one is left over. This cannot be made it into group. Okay. It has no pair for it. This has no pair. In the same way, if I have five balls, you will get two pairs. Okay. You will get two pairs and one is left over, it has no pair. Isn't it? It has no pair. Such numbers are called odd numbers. Okay. Such numbers are called odd numbers. We cannot make a pair of these numbers. Okay. So, when you group it into two, one will be left over. When you group it into two, one will be left over without pair. Such numbers are called odd numbers. So the numbers like 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 are odd numbers. Okay. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are odd numbers. So Even numbers means 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are even numbers and 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are odd numbers. Then, so beyond this means next numbers like 2 digit numbers, in 2 digit numbers, how to find even and odd numbers. So, when you are finding the even and odd numbers, suppose in the 2 digit numbers, you have to check the digit in the ones place, okay? You have to check the digit in the ones place. So, the digit in the ones place, if it has 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, then that is an even number. Okay, that is an even number. And the digit in the ones place is 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. That is an odd number. So, next we have 10. Here in the 10, there is 0 in the ones place. It is an even number. The next number is 11. Here in the 10, ones place, there is 1. Isn't it? So, it is an odd number. 11 is an odd number. Next comes 12. There is 2 in the ones place. Hence, it is an even number. And 13, there is 3 in the ones place. 3. Hence, it is an odd number. So, even number follows odd number. Odd number follows even number. Okay. So, alternative numbers. Alternatively, it comes alternatively. Even number after odd number, next even number, the next after odd number, like that. Even number follows odd number follows even number. Clear? So, to identify the even and odd numbers, you must check the digit in the ones place. So, in the ones place, the digit, if the number is having 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 in its ones place, that is an even number. The number having 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 in its ones place is an odd number. So, here there are set of numbers. Let us see. First, let us circle even numbers. Okay, first let us circle the even numbers in this group of numbers. So, first there is 4. 4 is an even number. So, circle it. 4 is even number. Next, 15 is there. 15. In this number, there is 5 in the ones place. Isn't it? There is 5 in the ones place. And we know that 5 is odd number, isn't it? 5 is odd number. So, this number 15 is odd number. Next is 18. And here there is 8 in the ones place. 8 is even number. Hence, this 18 is even number. Circle it. Got it? Next, 29. In this, there is 9 in the ones place. And 9 is odd number. So, 29 is odd number. Next comes 32. 2 is even number. Hence, this number 32 is even number. Next we have 46. There is 6 in the ones place and 6 is even number. So this number 46 is even number. 47. 7. There is 7 in the ones place. It is odd number. Hence 47 is odd number. And 54. So here there is 4 in the ones place. So this number is even number. 4 is even number. So, 54 is even number. There is 9 in the ones place here. And this is odd number. So, 59 is odd number. 61. There is 1 in the ones place. Hence, this number is odd number. Next, we have 4 in the ones place. So, 64 is even number. Okay. So, there is 8 here. 8 in the ones place. So, we know that 8 is even number. Hence, 78 is even number. Next one is 83. So 3 is odd number. So this number 83 is odd number. So the rounded circled numbers are even numbers, and these numbers without circle, these are odd numbers. Clear? So the number in its one space, if it has 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, they are even numbers. And in the one space, the number has 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Such numbers are odd numbers. So this is how you have to find even and odd numbers. I hope you understood. Complete exercise 1.13 in your textbook. Thank you.